रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताय पतये नमः। अंजना नंदनम वीरम जानकी शोकनाशनम कपीशमक्षहंतारम वंदे लंका भयंकरम कूजंतम रामरामीति मधुरम मधुराक्षरम आरुह्य कविता शाखा वंदे वाल्मीकि कोकिलम। हरिओम। सो दिस टॉपिक, आई हैव टेकन दिस टॉपिक in many centers. Many of you would have heard this same topic. Again, we are going to study the same topic. Anyway, studying about drama is always very, gives us pleasure. So many times, as many times you read, that many times you get so much of clarity. So we have two Itihasas. So one is Ramayana, another one is Mahabharata. Ramayana is by our Valmiki Maharishi and Mahabharata by Bhagavan Vedavyasa. So both of these two Itihasas are talking about the essence of Vedas. That's all. So we call Mahabharata as a Panchama Veda. The fifth Veda is called Mahabharata. Actually, Vedas means it is revealed, the revelation of rishis. Only mantras, in the form of mantras, all the Vedas are in the form of mantras. Then how can you call Mahabharata as a Panchama Veda? So it has the content of Vedas. Therefore, the Mahabharata is Panchama Veda. We say this man is walking, this the lion is coming. This is someone, lion is coming. This is not lion. This man is walking like lion. Very rarely we see that kind of people. Man is walking like lion. So when we compare this person as, with the lion, it doesn't mean that lion itself is coming there. No. The same way, Panchama Veda means it is not revelation of rishis. The Bhagavan Vedavyasa, he studied all the Vedas, grasped all the Vedas, and he brought out the essence of Vedas in the form of Itihasa through some story. So Mahabharata is essence of Vedas. Although it is very difficult to understand Vedic ideas, but we can understand the Vedic ideas through stories. So that story also is not the fabricated story or imagination imaginated by our Bhagavan Vedavyasa. So whatever has happened, that's why this is called Itihasa. Iti abdina, like this, very definitely, asa happened. It has happened definitely, Itihasa. So this is the Mahabharata between Pandavas and Kauravas. Well, we also have Pandavas and Kauravas in our families. Who is Pandava? Who is Dharmaraja among the Pandava? Me. So we have Pandavas and Kauravas in our family. So there also we had Pandavas and Kauravas. The fight between Dharma and Adharma. We can understand what is Dharma and Adharma through these stories. So Bhagavan Vedavyasa worked very hard. He did homework on the Vedas and he brought out. So before Bhagavan Vedavyasa, we had Valmiki Maharishi. Valmiki Maharishi, see, he studied the life history of Rama and he thought that we can bring this life history of Rama to the common man. He can understand what is the standard of life. So I have to bring the standard of life of human being for the rest of the human beings. So Bhagavan Valmiki Maharishi was sitting in the forest, sitting in the river bank and started thinking, I have to give some model or ideal, so that the rest of the people can follow this fellow, this man. So he was searching that kind of person, Valmiki. At that time, Narada Maharishi visited Valmiki Rishi's ashram. So even though he had that kind of idea, not very much clear idea he had, at the same time, he thought that Rama would be the nice person. So when he had that kind of question in his mind, Valmiki, at that time, Sita Devi also is living in that ashram. and she had the two children, Lavakusha. So after all this Ramayana has happened, Ravana Vada has happened, after Ravana Vada and what do you call the Pattabhishekam, so Rama asked Sita to go to forest. Now Sita is living in Valmiki's ashram. And Valmiki also heard about Rama. So this is the life history. I think this person must be the right person to show for the rest of the human being. Valmiki had that. But he has to confirm that. Sometimes you will understand the concept of Maya and Brahman. Go to study class. I can understand Brahman, but it's very difficult to understand Maya. So you want to confirm that idea. If any the teacher comes, the Vedantic teacher, then you go and ask whether my understanding is right or not. Otherwise, we will not say our understanding. So what is Maya and what is Brahman? Can you clarify? So when he explains, then he will, my understanding also right. In the same way, Valmiki also heard about Rama. Because Sita Devi is in Valmiki's ashram only. So when Narada Maharishi visited Valmiki, Valmiki asked a few questions. So Valmiki reflected and he brought 16 qualities of human beings. I do not know what kind of the men he met in his life, Valmiki. That's why he brought 16 kinds of good qualities. Very rare to see. And he is asking Narada Maharishi, hey Bhagavan, have you seen any person in this world who has got all the 16 qualities? As we say in Tamil, we say, Padinaarum Petru Peruvaalvum Aazhuga. Padinaarum means 16 qualities. Okay? Now we'll see. So what kind of 16 qualities he is asking our Valmiki Maharishi to Narada Rishi. This is Lord Rama. When we learn Ramayana, or when we study, when we hear Ramayana, bro, the basic concept we'll have in our mind. Rama means the Lord. Okay? Om Ramaya Namaha, Rama Bhadraya Namaha, Rama Chandra Vishnu Puja. Keep his photo in the puja hall and do puja. We'll keep Rama as the Lord. Avatara Purusha. The Lord Vishnu has taken the avatar. Now you keep this Rama in the puja hall and you start doing puja. We'll miss so many things about Rama. So here what our Valmiki Rishi is doing. So this Rama is none other than Vishnu. Yeah, he says that Vishnu himself has arrived as Rama. But this Rama is not the divine Rama. So divinity, you take the divinity and put that side. You take the human aspect of the Rama, which is very, very helpful to our life, to make our life very, what that, very happy, comfortable, and very peaceful. So Valmiki is describing human aspect of Rama in Valmiki Ramayana. In this Ramayana. So first thing we have to understand that. Otherwise, what is happening in our life, we'll keep Rama in the puja hall and we start doing the puja. Once if we start doing the puja, then we are not seeing his human qualities. And whenever we have a problem, when I read Ramayana, we do not know how to take lessons from Ramayana. Instead of taking lessons from Ramayana, we say, he is Rama, he can do. I'm at least an ordinary human being. I don't have anything. We'll compromise all our ideas or weakness. So we are unable to come out of the weakness and set the standard. That's the problem. So in the beginning itself, we have to set the right direction. In which direction you are taking this Ramayana? That is very, very important. Most of the time we are making this mistake. When I study Krishna, he is Krishna. A very ordinary human being. Sir, for ordinary human being only, Bhagavan came as Rama. And he has done something. From his life, you can take some lessons. Try your best and you can come out of your one level to next level or higher level. So first we have to set this kind of the settings in our mind. Before starting the computer, setting irukla, you go and set illa resetting, setting, resetting, refitting. So far we studied Ramayana, Rama the Lord. Okay, so the divine aspect, there's no problem, let it be there. You take the human aspect of Rama, then we learn so many things, making our life little better than the earlier life. That is the point. Is it okay? Otherwise, why we have to study Ramayana? Rama took avatar, it's okay, very good. He married Sita, oh, lucky fellow. His father-in-law is Janaka Maharaj, oh, very good, nice person. Janaka Maharaj did not make any mistake with the problem with the son-in-law, very good relationship. He had for three brothers, oh, nice fellow. No, the property dispute. Oh, what a great family members. Rama had very nice servant, Hanuman. Oh, very good. We never had that kind of servants in our personal life. So when we study about why we have to study his life, spending our time. When we study, we have to learn some values to be followed in our life, making our life a little better. Okay? So Rama the ideal man. Man the Ingen. Not Avatara Purusha. Avatara Purusha means he has got extraordinary power to accomplish. There are so many unimaginable tasks. Rama is doing unimaginable tasks. Building bridge in the ocean and going to Lanka. There are so many great things. So that kind of powerful activities, divine activities, belong to that kind of the yuga. Treta Yuga, we can do it. But in the Kali Yuga, it's very difficult. You cannot take even a small chair for half an hour. Small table. Very difficult. In Kali Yuga, the capacity of the human being is totally different from Treta Yuga. Okay? So we are looking at Ramayana, Rama as human being. So at the same time, we should not think, oh, he's a human being. I thought he's Lord Vishnu. Sir, so Lord Vishnu only has come in the human form. But we are taking the divine form that side and studying about a human form. So we have to understand that. Now, this is the question asked by our Valmiki Rishi to Narada Rishi. Konvas means Sampradam Loke. Sampradam means now. Sampradam Loke, now itself. Hey Bhagavan Narada Rishi, I'm not asking the person who lived somewhere in the Purva Yugas. I'm asking you, have you seen any person who is living right now? Right now, Sampradam Loke. A living model. Sampradam means the living model. I want to show the living model to the society. Konvas means Sampradam Loke. Asmin Loke, in this world, have you seen right now any person who lives with the 16 qualities? So why you are asking about the 16 qualities? Because it's reflected. I think that any person has got the 16 qualities is called complete person, the ideal person. Okay? Gunavan kaha, first. This is a sloka. I split the sloka and I am giving you a small individual values. Okay? You take this there. Okay? What is this? Deepavali patas, crackers, okay? Saravedi. This is a saravedi. 100 pieces. 100 pieces. We'll take this sara separated. He separates every vedi and he starts. He wants to extend the happiness of the crackers. Okay? You understood? So again, take one crackers and break it up. the same way, the shloka is broken into one known value. The complete shloka is broken into one known value. Konvasmin sampradam loke gunavan kascha vidyavan dharmajnyascha kritajnyascha satyavakyo dridavartaha. One shloka. So if I split the shloka, gunavan kaha, virtuous, the person who has got the virtues, gunavan, gunangal. Guna, these are the values, virtues. Gunavan kaha, viryavan kaha, powerful. The interesting point, if we are gunavan, we will not have virya, power will not be there. All Hindus, gunavan, viryam, no. That's why somebody is calling our devatas, will keep quiet. Why devatas got weapons, the devata will fight. Sir, they are scolding at your devatas. Aham gunavan, na viryavan. Valmiki said, many people I see in this world, they have guna, values, but the virya is not there. Interesting, right? Suppose if you have virya, guna will disappear. Guna will go. If you have a very powerful, guna will go. See how he reflected. Guna should be there, the same time virya should be there. You try to bring peace in your mind. A sattvika. You go to Vedanta class, you study Sama, Dama, Uparama, Ditiksha, Siddhanda, Samadhara. Finished. Whatever the virya you had already has gone. Viveka, Vairagya, Vairagya. Vairagya means I will not touch anything. Shama, Dama, Uparama, Ditiksha, Siddhanda, Samadhara. Mokshuttam, that's all. Even the car also, you will not drive very, car very soft over that, what do you call it? Soft turning. Why? Sattvika. Virya will go. So Valmiki observed these things. The human beings as gunavan. At the same time, virya also should be there. Okay? Dharma jnaha, one who knows what is dharma. Knowing what is dharma and adharma. Dharmajna means adharmajna also. What is dharma and what is adharma? Dharmajnaha. Many times we have confusion. What is to be done, what is not to be done. Arjuna also had this kind of problem in the battlefield. Krishna never had that kind of confusion. Rama never had that kind of confusion in his life. Dharmajna, dharma sammuda cheta. Le? Arjuna had dharma sammuda cheta. Krishna never had, Rama never had. Why? Dharmajna. They are very, very clear about what is dharma, what is adharma. Dharmajna. In our case, we are totally different in our life. So the word dharma itself is taking so many years to understand. Then afterwards, dharmajna. Very difficult. The person who knows dharma. Next, kritajna, gratitude. The person should have the gratitude. Valmiki says, even a small iota of a thing if you do for Rama, Rama never forget that kind of help. He never forgets. Kritajna. Small help also he will remember throughout the life. But you see what kind of human being, you see, he is getting so much from us. Every day, every week, every year you give. One day you don't give, finished. What you have given? So many years I have given, that is there. But today you didn't give. Worst, so many people we see in our world. Cheap. You swallowed everything one day, only one day you missed, but you lost all your kritajna, Rama. Even if a small help, throughout the life he will remember. Kritajna. Very rare to see this kind of... Now see, we study Vedanta, Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, different. The values are very, very important. So if you develop this kind of value, then study of Vedanta will give so much of profit and benefit. Otherwise, what we are telling, you study Vedanta, you teach Vedanta, you understand Vedanta, very intricate part of the philosophy. Everything is okay. But see, I don't respect this fellow. I don't have any love for this. Why? The man doesn't have this kind of values. Patram is not clean. Only content is there. So in Rama's life, the patra is very clean. Once the patra is very clean, then you pour the milk. Milk will be very good. Otherwise, the spoiled milk. The vessel is not good. Making the vessel first clear, then we have to pour this milk. Yeah, see the good values. Satya Vakya speaks truth. Rare quality. Dhridavarta, steadfastness. Dhridavarta. It's not shaky. Today, Ekadesi, I'm not going to take no sweet. A particular day it comes, Tirunelveli, Alva. Ayoyo. Just 1 hour back only, I took this Vratam. Okay, next week, Ekadesi, I will observe next week. Today, this Ekadesi, I will cancel. Why? Alva has come from Tirunelveli. Once you have taken Dhridavarta, go to forest for 14 years. Not compromising on a single day. Dhridavarta. Then the Bharata goes and has come back. So when we go to forest, we will expect that looking at the direction of Kosala, somebody is coming or not. Nobody is coming. Mosanda. They are waiting to go to forest. Nobody is coming. Oh, that Bharata will come. We will expect. Bharata went and what that arguing with Rama, you have to come back. Rama never came back. Dhridavarta. Interesting, eh? Charitra nacha koyukta, possess of right conduct. Charitra. You never find any fault with Rama's charitra. But by ordinary people only find fault. Rama sent Sita to a forest. Rama doubted Sita. Ordinary Prakrita Purusha's comment. Valmiki says, Charitre nacha koyuktaha. Sarvabhuteshu koyuktaha. Friendly to all living beings. The ordinary person has got some standard. I will talk only to this kind of people. That's all. This is my standard of. I'll talk to this kind of people. If standard goes down, I will not talk. Rama, you take Rama. Jatayu, Jambavan, Vibhishana, Hanuman, all this work. See the community of Rama. Devatas, rishis, human beings. Oh, bah. Sarvabhuteshu kohitaha. Rama's community, he just embraced Vasudeva Kudumbakam. He showed us Vasudeva Kudumbakam. Is it bats, birds community or monkeys community or bears community or Rakshasa community? All the community. He belongs to all communities. Sarvabhuteshu koitaha, vidwan kaha, man of knowledge. We know very little, but we think that we know everything. This is the top. Very little. Only 2 Upanishads studied. Mastered all the Upanishads. Sir, in that Upanishad also, you have so many doubts. Not clear. Small text we study in a man of knowledge. Rama knows everything. Vidwan. No doubt. Samartha. Capable of any task. Samarthya Sali. Capable of doing any task. So people will be very knowledge, but they don't have even small. They don't know how to ride the car. Anything happens, just tell you stop the car and call the mechanic. A simple the thing, we do not know how to do it. Samartha. Yes. Kaha yeka priyadarshanaha, loving appearance. It is very, by birth only we get. Otherwise we can make some arrangement. The lotion, powder, mau, something we can apply and we try to show. That's 1 hour. So after 1 hour, it will go away. Summer season finished. The original form will come. Now summer started in India. Just half an hour. Go out, come in, finished. Eka Priyadarshana. Even without any cosmetics also. Sada Eka Priyadarshana. Loving appearance. Okay? Atmavan kaha, subdued the self. Atmavan. One who has complete control over himself. Atmavan. So Atmavan has got so many interpretations also you can do. Atma, one who knows Atma. One who abides in his own nature. Atmavan kaha. kaha jitakrodha, jitakrodha conquered anger. Conquered anger means we understand that you never get angry. That's called conquering the anger. Sir, that is not conquering the anger. So this man never gets angry in his life. Ayyayyo, there is some mental problem. If you are not getting angry, there is some psychological problem. Sir, you have to get, the anger is very nice quality. When to use, where to use, how much to use. So Gurudev says, it's like a pen, you have a pen. Whenever it's needed, you take the pen and write down and put it the pen in its own place. So, Valmiki says in the first chapter of Valmiki Ramayana. The first chapter is called Samkshepa Ramayana. The whole Ramayana, 100 slokas he writes, first chapter. Kalagni Sadrusha Kurode. When Rama gets the angry, when he becomes very angry person, Kalagni Sadrusha, he looks like Kalagni, like Lord Shiva. Kshamaya Prithivi Samaha. Immediately he comes down like what the passions like earth, Mother Earth. Kalagni Sadrusha Kurodaha, Kshamaya Prithivi Samaha. Immediately he brings the sloka. So conquered anger means conquered jita kurodha. Kurodha is under his control. Kurodha means not here aversion. Kurodha means anger. Okay, anger. His control. Complete control. So in our case, kurodha is controlling us. Once if I become angry, 1 week it will take to come back. Some small thing will get upset. I don't want. I'm angry. Okay, it has happened in the morning, leave it. How can I leave it? We'll disturb the whole day. At the same time, we'll disturb other people also. Our Jitakuradaha, Rama set the standard. Jitakura, one who conquered the anger. In our case, we are 100% under the anger. 100%. Suppose the person is getting angry morning, 6 o'clock, okay, before the class. Why? The computer is not there. Somebody made some problem. I'm not able to connect. So we became angry after over the 2 hours. If you come out of the anger, then 80% you are Rama. Just after 2 years, 2 hours you are coming back. Suppose half a day you have, then 50% you are Rama. 50% value. Oh, no. If you come back over that half day, okay? Immediately if you come back, then 80%. If you know how to handle it without anger, then you are 100%. Suppose 2 days you are angry. 10% human being. 1 week, only 1%. The whole life you are having that one incident, that anger in your mind, then you are minus 10%. Zero, minus lapu. So we can take this jita kuro, only kurodha, we can set our that mind with Rama. So Rama is completely jita kurodha. 100% mark Rama has got when he is handling the anger. In our case, we will come back from the anger half a day or 2 hours or 1 year. Okay, if something happens in our life. So how far you are coming out of your anger? How you are bouncing back to our normal sthiti? So this is the standard we have to take. How Rama handled the anger, how we are handling the anger. So we have to go to Rama's. So we are here, okay? Rama is here. Then we have to go to Rama's state and said, this is what Valmiki asked Narada Rishi. I want to set the standard of all the values the human being should understand, and they have to try to go to Rama's. What kind of the brilliant person is it? A very, very brilliant person, Dhyutiman. Ko anasuyaka, finding, fault finding. This is a simple thing. Find fault with others. We never find fault with us. If somebody points out the fault, then we will not talk with that person forever. get out from my life. First you get out from my WhatsApp group. That's all. Deleted. Why? I'm the admin. I have all the power to do. Admin, delete. Then you don't invite that person for any function. Why? He is finding fault with me. We should not find that fault with others, not fault finding. See, we have to understand, not fault finding. Suppose the person is sitting in the interview panel and you are recruiting the person for the company. At that time, you have to see the person as it is. This is the fault this person has got. This is the positive values he has got. So at that kind of, that time, finding the fault with the person, you are going to take this person in the company. That is not fault finding. You have to see the person as it is. Fault finding means you are not able to bear the growth of the other person. At that time, deliberately you are finding some fault. We try to pull that person down from its place. That is called asuya. Asuya is different. And as you're sitting in the interview panel and you're finding the person, this is the person's fault. If this person comes in the company, then he can spoil the company. Please delete this fellow from the list. I hope you are understanding. And the understanding of the value is very, very important. So we should not take this as it is. So we have to refine the value and we have to take it. So when we study this kind of values, if you misunderstand, then we make a mess of the positive value itself will become negative in our life. Suppose you go and see very good boy for our girl. See, our girl should get married. You find this. And the boy is having some problem. So you say, no, I'm not. I'm following Ramayana. I'm not finding any fault with this boy. Okay, I can take this boy. Hello? Be practical. Analyze and take this. Family is not good, but this boy is very good. So family also important, sir. So I'm not finding any fault with this family. So family is criminal family, sir. And so I'm not finding fault because I am anasuya kaha. I'm following Ramayana. Yo. Then you will be in problem. Deep problem. So when you take this value, applying. So when you apply, we need to have a very different kind of mindset or clarity. I hope you will understand this point. Okay? So this is where we are making the mistake. Not finding fault means it's not like this. So asuya is different and knowing the person as it is different. Okay, next. Kasya bibhyati devascha jato roshasya samyuge. When Rama gets angry, even God's fear of him in the battlefield. The battlefield. Because this is a battlefield, he has to become very powerful. Devas also will get angry. They will the fear. That is the power of Rama. Very nice value. All 16 values. Yes. Padinaram Petru Peruvalu Varga. Padinaram Petru means we have to get all the 16 values, not 16 children. In Tamil Nadu, we misunderstood that 16 children you get to be happy. Ada Pavi. One child is tough to bring this child up. It's very difficult. Petru means after gaining. In Tamil Nadu, Petru means that getting the child. The Petru, the word. Gaining. After gaining the 16 values, make your life very high standard life. Okay, every value you take, we'll get the Atmavan. Sir, 1%, because we studied Atmabodham Tattvabodham. 1%. Conquering anger. Okay, 2%. Brilliance. Okay, 10%. Not fighting fault. 50% mark. Kasya bibhyati devascha, jato roshasya. I never had this kind of battlefield. Therefore, it's not. I'm not eligible. In a battlefield. My house is battlefield. I never take any weapon. All other people only taking a weapon. That's all. Now if you give your mark, 1%, 2%, like that only you will get. Rama's 100% mark. Okay? Rama's 100%. All the 16 Christian values. Edadichamaham shrotum param kautuhalam kime. Param kautuhalam. All the enthusiasm. I want to know the person. Enthusiastic. When you ask the question, the enthusiasm should be there. Because I want to learn about this person. Kautuhalam. Kutuhalam. Param kutuhalam kime. Valmiki says, oh, I'm very happy to know this person. So when I ask the question, the student should be very, very receptive and very happy to learn. Param kautuhalam kime maharishe tvam maharishe, oh Lord. Maharishe means, oh Narada Maharishi, tvam samarthahasi. You are the person, you are the eligible person to explain this kind of the ideal man to me. Nyatum evam vidam naram. I want to know about this man. This is the very, very important line you have to understand. Valmiki says, naram, not avatara purusham. So Valmiki never asks, I want to know the avatara purusha. So I'm not interested in avatara purusha. I'm interested in the human beings, ordinary human beings. I want to show them nice idea. Therefore, if you know the person, the human being, knowing such a man, okay, the man is very, very. So when you read Valmiki Ramayana, you have to understand Valmiki is interested in human beings. Gurudev was, he was interested in human beings. He came out of the Himalayas, Bhagavad Gita Upanishad, to lift our life. Our compassion. Compassion means not the speaking very softly and crying always. Hey, that is not compassion. The heart is filled with love. So we have to do something for this one. In our case, compassion means, oh, how are you? Are you? Ah. That is compassion. we misunderstood. Compassion means how to talk very slowly. Oh, oh. This is the expression of compassion. Otherwise, you have to cry. Oh, compassion, heart is crying. So I also thought when you look at our Gurudev, he is very majestic, speaks very loudly, like lion. So many people with compassion, what kind of compassion? See, it looks very dry. So many years back when I joined Sandeep, I compassionate. I never say any compassion. He is not crying. Not very softly speaking. What kind of compassion? Misunderstanding of the buddhi. We are that kind of tamasic buddhi. Oh, no, compassion is not like that. Melting heart for the human being. So we have to do something for the human. The heart is melting. Not crying or speaking very. So Valmiki also sitting in the forest thinking about the human being. Simply they are not sitting in the forest and eating fruits, salad, carrot, beetroot, apple, mango. They're not eating and spending their life. They're thinking about the human being. I have to set the standard for the rest of the human being. Naram. So Valmiki is interested in human beings, not the devatas also. So have you seen any person? Because you move around the world. Oh, Narada Maharishi, you are moving in the Triloka Sanchari. You know many people. Therefore, I'm asking you, you are the right person. Samartha, see, you are the Samartha person. You can tell me the right person. Okay, this is the question. Very main question of this Ramayana. Then Ramayana starts. Then he started giving the whole Ramayana. In 100 slokas, the complete Ramayana, 100 slokas he gives our Valmiki. Then afterwards, the Narada Maharishi. Then Valmiki Maharishi, he sat in meditation. He started seeing the whole Ramayana in his tapas. So whatever happened from from childhood of the Rama, then till what do you call the Ravanavada. So afterwards, what will happen? The Uttarakhand also he writes. What will happen afterwards? This is how the Ramayana came. The question is it's like this. Every Upanishad starts with Upanishad is answer for this question. Mundaka Upanishad, this is the answer for this question. So when you take the Upanishad, one question is answered in that Upanishad. So that has become the big the philosophy. The same. So what is Ramayana? Valmiki's question is answered by Narada Maharishi. That has become Ramayana. So he has taken the life history of Rama. So now, according to Valmiki, Rama is a human being, not Avatar Purusha. Because he wants to bring very great values in our life. So that is the intention of Valmiki. Okay? So Valmiki is Adikavi. First person of Valmiki was brought the shloka type. First, before Valmiki, so all the things we have studied in the form of mantra, Vedic mantras only. The shloka, the shloka formation. First person, the whole tradition, the framed shloka is Valmiki. Therefore, we call Valmiki as Adi Kavi. He's a kavi. He started singing the song. Before Valmiki, all Vedic mantras only. Mantras are revelation. The poem is composed. Valmiki only composed the first shloka, the whole tradition. Therefore, we call Adi Kavi on the Valmiki. Okay? So, Adi Kavyam, the Valmiki Ramayana. Then many, many people studied Valmiki Ramayana and they brought their idea also in that Ramayana. Without changing the basic story, they brought many changes according to the time, the need of the time, need of the society. They had that right. The poets had that kind of right and they had the blessings of Lord Rama to change this kind of, to bring the modifications. That's the glory of Sanatana Dharma. So no religion will allow to touch the original text. When they study the original text, they are retelling the story. They are not changing any shlokas in the Valmiki. They study any kavi, if it is Kamban, studied Valmiki Ramayana, and he has his own imaginations to retelling the story. So you go and attend one program, 50 people, and you go back to your home, and you are telling in your own way to your children. 50 people learned one lesson from one person and 50 people are representing 50 style according to their ability in the same way. So the first one is Valmiki and there are so many Ramayana. Hundreds of Ramayanas are written in different language by different poets. But root is Valmiki. So we are seeing the original, the root. Okay, this is the question. Now see this. The father, the king. Dasaratha has acted as father or king. For Rama, Dasaratha is the father at the same time, the king. The two roles Dasaratha had in Ramayana. Now, mother. He has got three mothers. Kausalya, Kaikeyi, Sumitra. Rama had three mothers. One mother is served under the person. The three mothers. Mothers, ministers, Vasishtha and other Sumantra, so many ministers. Wife Sita Devi, only one. Ekapatni Vartanis. Brothers. This is Okamata, Okabarya, Okabana. So only one arrow, only one wife, and one mantra. Rama. Okay, wife Sita Devi. The brothers, Bharata, Lakshmana and Shatrughna. And he had friends, Guha, Sugriva and Vibhishana. See the community. Guha from the tribe. Sugriva, the monkey community. Vibhishana, Rakshasa community. So he's not the king from next country, this king from that country, this king from... Sir, Guha, Sugriva, Vibhishana. And people are there. So I don't have this space. That's why I put this Kamahi. Jambavan, Hanuman. So many people. Neela, Nala. Okay? Right. Now see. Sevak. So we should not put servant under. Sevaks. Hanuman and other Vanaras. Rama had in his life. Opponent, Ravana. And other people also. But Ravana is very main the opponent. Along with Ravana, so many people are coming there. Administration. Admin means not here, password admin, what you are having in the technical, the digital world. This is administration. I don't have space, that's why. So, the Kosala country, Kosala, Ayodhya. Kosala country and Ayodhya's capital. Teacher is Vishwamitra. Here, Vasishtha also teaches Rama, but Vishwamitra, he took him to the practical field and he taught him so many things. So Vasishtha was working as a teacher at the same time minister. That's why I brought Vasishtha the ministers. list. There are so many things Rama had in his life. So whatever we have in our life, Rama also had. That is a point. Okay. You have father. Okay. So king, you take it. You have father. Mother also is mother. So how to deal with the father, how to deal with the mother. Dealing with mother is very easy. Father, you dry fellow. It's very difficult. No feeling. Sometimes dealing with the father is very easy. Whatever you say, yes, that's all. But dealing with the mother is very difficult. She knows so many things. Very sharp. Mother sharp on the, you are gali. She will have doubt in every statement. Why? Yeah? Ayoyo. So mother is very sharp. How to deal with mother? Ministers. Sometimes ministers has got more knowledge than the king. As a mantra alochana, they are only giving the ideas for the king. So you have to deal with the ministers. Wife, you have choice here. If you marry, you get wife and husband. If you do not, lucky, then you miss that part. See, then the option then. Rama had this. Rama married and lived with Sita. That's why your role was brothers. Bharata Lakshmana. So how to deal with them? Friends. Guha, Sugriva, Vibhishana. How to deal with the friends? That's also savaks. If you do not get 2 days, 3 days, the servant who is taking care of your house finished. Your regular work will affect like anything. I'm telling in India, not in America. In America, if you have the savaks finished, servant. So whatever you get money, half of the money should go to their bank account. In India, if you don't get the people for 2-3 days finished. So opponent, how to deal with them? Admin. How to do your own administration, your own house also you have administration. Not only we have to understand the administration means only the company or office in the house, also is administration only. Okay, teacher, how to deal with the teacher. There are so many things in our life. Life means what? This is the human life. This is the human life. Life means what? If you analyze, these are the things you are going to deal with. So say, suppose if you get some fever and all, it's very easy to deal. You take an injection or some medicine, it's very easy to deal. The physical disease when you get, it's very easy. Comparatively easy. Here also we get problem, but comparatively it's very easy, easy to deal. But all this, because of this people, only this kind of thing only, we get a stress and a mental problem. We lose our peace. There are so many problems. This is the because of this thing in our life. This is life. So how to deal with these people very effectively? Then we have to read Ramayana. Hello. Okay. Ramayana means not Rama's life. Through Rama's life, how he dealt this kind of people. All the things. So only one thing we don't get. We are not king of any country, luckily. We have to thank God. You know, the people will be having the schedule. Say, sir, you have to go to this time here. The personal secretary will come and he will make all the schedule. You cannot do anything, whatever you like. The king, the schedule is totally different. Okay? Except this. I do not know. You may become the president of USA or prime minister of India. It's possible. But this is very rare. Other than this, all the things we have in our life. So how to deal all this thing? Now I go to Ramayana. This is the person, the complete ideal person. And he has become the nice student for his teacher, the ideal student. Okay, Rama. Ideal. What are the qualities he had to become ideal student? Because he had teacher Vishwamitra and all. As an ideal son. Why? He had mother and father. For mother and father, how I have to present myself. The role is there. Different roles he has taken. He has taken brother. Lakshmana, Bharata and Shatrughna. So as a brother, how I have to express myself to three brothers? Husband, because married. So what is my role with Sita Devi? Then somebody has taken Sita Devi, the Rakshasa. How I have to react when I get her back? Other role. So when somebody is talking about, even then I made this kind of the Agni Pariksha. She has went through this kind of test. The people are talking bad about her. What is my role as husband? So he has to take some tough decision. Other role of husband, role of friend. So how I have to deal with Bhishana, Sugriva and Guha. So what is my role? How I have to deal? As a father, I get two children now. As a father, how I have to bring up my children? Now Sita is carrying these twins. Where to send Sita now? A very big question. As a father, I have to see the twins, the two children, the future of two children. So where to send? That's a big, big decision, okay? As a head of the family. So he is the family head and he went to forest 14 years. And Bharata is taking care of the property. Whether I come back, if Bharata is attached to the property and the power, so what will happen after 14 years? So if you have a company, because you are going out, you ask someone to take care of the company for 10 days, that's all. You ask him to sit in your chair, finished. When you come back, you will not come out of this chair. Otherwise, he will become boss number two. For 10 days, you are asking a person to take care that within the 10 days, he becomes so attached and he will be the problematic person in the company. Okay, 14 years, the person sitting there, taking care of the property and the power, when Rama comes back, suppose Bharata is attached with this, so what Rama has to do as a family member? Head of the family, right? So that is also given in Ramayana. Whether Bharata is attached or not. Rama is asking Hanuman, hey, Hanuman, you go back and tell Bharata, I am coming back. You see, if you see any reaction on his face, just to tell me, I can go to forest, I can live the rest of the life in the forest itself. I don't want to get to Kosala Rajya. Rama says, if Bharata is very happy in my return, then I can come to Kosala Rajya. Yeah. So what kind of standard he has got? Powerful. That's why we have the history of Lord Rama. So family head. So what is his role? The opponent in the battlefield went to kill Ravana. So this is a very nice slokas. We'll see in the future studies. Okay. Leader of the team. So how he was dealing the team of monkeys. As a king, so how I have to take care of this kingdom. One person made a mistake in a system. The powerful king. The powerful king of Ramasubha. Therefore, we call it Ramarajyam. Ramarajyam. So what is happening? What was happening in Ramarajyam? Ramarajyam means what? Then you have to study the Ayodhya God. How Rama was ruling the country. One person made a mistake. Rama went and killed him on the spot. Shambhu Kanurta. So he went out of his duty. So some killed on the spot. Powerful king. If anybody is moving from the duty, he will be killed on the spot. And the punishment will be very, very powerful. Then only the mass can be kept in the discipline. The mass control will not come otherwise. Powerful king. Administration. See? So he has taken the student, son, brother, husband, all these roles. This is the role. All the roles we are also taking in our life. So how to handle this kind of people? Okay. How to handle this kind of people in our life? So what kind of role we have to take in our life? This is the essence of Ramayana. Have you understood? So it's an ideal person. So Rama is setting standard for 100%. All 100%. All 100% is life. Because why? The standard. If a question paper is 100%, then the question paper, the maximum mark 100. If you get 60%, then you are getting first class student. Any question paper, maximum mark 100. Sir, I got 60%, sir. Okay, first class. Sir, 35%, sir. Pass. Sir, 30%. You are in border. Fail. fail or fail, fail bad. So if you get 35% of Rama's value, nice person of society, 60% first class person, 70, 80, oh, distinction is almost you are like Rama. Okay, so we have to raise ourselves from the present condition to Rama's state, you know, standard. This is what Valmiki said in Ramayana. This is called Ramayana. Okay? So we have to set our life standard through the study of Ramayana. So all the incidents in Rama's life is giving us very nice what that angle or approach, how to adjust our life. Okay? Interestingly. So Rama has set the stand. Oh, the whole story is going like this. Rama took avatara in Ayodhya and studied under the guidance of Vasishtha Maharishi. Vishwamitra came and took him to the forest. Okay? In the forest, what are the things he learned from Vishwamitra? Then he married Sita Devi. Then after some of that problem happened, then they went to forest. Then the Surpanaka came. Maricha came. Ravana took away Sita Devi. So Rama started searching Sita. He could not. With the help of that, because Jatayu told him, this is the direction in which he has taken Sita Devi. So Rama went searching Sita Devi. He met Sugriva. With the help of Sugriva, he killed Vali. So Kishkindha Raja is given to Sugriva. With the help of Sugriva and Hanuman, Hanuman is a minister of Sugriva. So automatically Hanuman started helping Rama. So all this the monkeys organized by Sugriva, they went in all direction, and particularly the southern direction, Hanuman, Jambavan, Nala, Neela, Angada, they went the southern direction. And Hanuman was asked to go to Lanka. Hanuman flew and he founded Sita Devi, and he has given all consolation to Sita Devi. He told that I will come with Rama, we'll kill Ravana, you will be taken back, you don't worry. So he consoled Sita Devi, he came back and told whatever the things happened in Lanka. So Rama started building the bridge in the ocean. The Rama took all the monkeys there, and the very well organized army of monkeys attacked Sita, the Lanka, and finished all the Rakshasas, brought back Sita Devi. He wants to glorify the Sita's glory. Therefore, Sita Devi went into Agni Pariksha, came back, and they took the charge of Kosala Raja, and they have done Pattabhishek. They lived very happily. So when they were living happily, the people talking bad about the Sita's charita, Nityapavada. So Rama asked Sita Devi to go to forest. Not forest, so he is handing over Sita Devi to Valmiki to take care. So she went to Valmiki's ashram. At that time, Valmiki is asking this question to Rishi Narada. Narada told, this is the Rama's history. Now Valmiki started writing the history of Rama. While Sita Devi was there in Valmiki's ashram. Okay, this is the story. Okay, the story of Ramayana is over in a few minutes. This is the line of the main line of the Ramayana. Okay, we study Ramayana. So from this whole Ramayana study, so we analyze when we take, this is the role Rama has taken in his life. Why we analyze when we take this role? So we are also having this kind of roles. So how he dealt in his life, the same way we also, when we deal, then our life will be better. That's the purpose. Is it okay? Now this is how we have to take any scripture, and if you approach in this way, we are completely benefited out of this kind of text. Lena, text will be very ideal. And our life is something somewhere else. And text is very ideal. And people are talking in our own house. You study Ramayana, Mahabharata, you behave very ordinary. What are you doing? You go to study class, study class, study class. No change. And they started scolding at us, criticizing us. So when you study in this way, then we bring very nice. We try to bring some transformation. So it will take more time. The idealistic me is different. The actual me is different. From the actual me, so we have to go to the idealistic me. It will take more time. Parallel, it's okay. But at least we understood where I am, where I have to go, what kind of steps I have to take. We understood, but it will take more time to go. Slowly, slowly we will climb. Okay, this is what Ramayana is teaching us. So we will continue tomorrow. This is very difficult to cover all the points. The few points we will cover. Anyway, after few months, April, May or June, July, we will start Ramayana study. So I'm going to take this Ramayana for 1 year, every Saturday, Sunday. So that I will inform you through CIF. Okay. So this you keep in your mind for a few days and we'll read elaborately the Ramayana. Even 2 years also we can take, no. Because we have very big life. 1 year to be where we'll take whole Ramayana, we'll study. Okay.